Hey everyone, are you staying warm out there? Well, the wind chill this morning in my neighborhood was close to 30 below zero, so it's pretty cold. And I am in the basement workshop working on models to show off on the show. This is Revell USA's 1968 Pontiac Firebird 400. It's in 1/25th scale. We always remember a lot of the 1/24th scale kits we see are old monogram kits released under the Revell brand. This is a Revell kit. It has 122 parts, and being a 68 Firebird, comes in at about 7.5 inches when completed. We got a nice set of box art on there, built up models on the side. I'm loving that green on green with a brown interior. I'm gonna have to see if I have any paints that could replicate that at all, because I think that's pretty cool. If not, we'll just have to find a different color to paint mine in. First up in the parts in the box, we've got one of the chrome trees. I say one because there are more, but check out that Firebird grill. This is not a GTO. I know I've built GTOs before. I'm not sure how many Firebirds I've built, but it hasn't been very many. I know I did the Revell 1/8 Trans Am and stuff like that. We've got blower parts here. I like when most of the blower is together. Air cleaner. We've got the pulleys. We've got shifters. We've got door handles, so be very careful. We've got a chrome oil pan. Valve covers there. Carburation. We've got the intake here. And I'm just really, really loving that grill. On the other tree, a multitude of wheel options. We've got wheel backs. We've got custom wheels, stock wheels. Really nice looking set on there. We'll get in close. You can see that they've all been molded open. Even the stock wheels, that's molded wide open there. Drag wheels, front wheels, sharp looking rig. We've got a set of clear parts, headlights, marker lights, rear glass, nice and crystal clear, front glass. Feels like it's got a good sized lip on it, so they must go from the inside. Visors are included on the windshield, tail lights, so it seems we'll have to do some transparent red painting. We've got a beautiful decal sheet here from Revell, red stripes. Total of 6 stock tires, drags. We've got an awesome hood, vent, roof, and tail stripe. Side stripes for the whole engine. Get it? Gauges, Firebird logos, 400 logos, Firebird emblems on there. We'll get in nice and close so you can see. Factory badging. 400 4 barrel and the big Firebird logo. Got some center console. Love that burled wood look. They've got that very right on there. And console, so that's awesome. Don't have to try to paint that on the car. Great looking decal sheet. And then an entire set of bias ply black walls, hollow. We'll stretch over the wheels easily. Nice tread pattern on there. And then a pair of slicks. We can sand that seam down pretty easy if we use those. Very hot, very flexible. Hollow, very flexible. When you sand those down, they rough up, look like tires that were used very nicely. So that is it on that side of the table. Now we will get to the rest of the 122 parts that are molded in white styrene. We've got 2 hood options. Love that scoop on there. And it has an indicator for the hood mounted tachometer. Door panels are separate on this one. It's molded in that nearly translucent Revell plastic, which accepts model glue very, very well. You could, if you wanted to, work on opening those scoops because they are all the way through. Nice detail underneath the hood for both of them. We've got a full chassis here. Nice large location mounts for the suspension, exhaust, springs. Great looking interior. Large engine mounts. Not going to have to wonder where to put those. I'm guessing these are for upper suspension arms. On this part here, we've got our interior floor, and the back seat's not even molded in. Very detailed. Center console. Dashboard looks great. Firewall is detailed. On the next tree, we've got our, what looks like it goes around our air intake for our hood scoops. Steering wheel, tail lights, so we can color those in and push them in. Center console option, bucket seats, racing seat. This is a 2-in-1 kit, drag or stock. On this tree here, we've got our front suspension, lower front suspension with steering, drive shaft, exhaust, and I love how the exhaust tips are cut out, alternator with bracket, cylinder heads, shocks and springs, differential, battery, radiator lines, all the good stuff on there. On this tree, we've got the belt and pulley system for our engine options, differential and springs, traction bars, roll cage, fan, air cleaner parts. People are really happy to see this kit back out. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. We've got our 400 there with transmission, stock intake, upper suspension arms like I guessed, brake booster. Got our radiator mount right there. Rest of our exhaust system. Optional headers, and those are beautiful. Large mounting points and everything. All one-piece molding. Blower scoop on there. Got our little tack for the hood hiding right there. I found it. Stock manifolds. Great-looking parts. And to wrap up the parts review on this kit, we've got that sweet Firebird body. Molded areas for the door handles. Open for the grill there. Front clip is attached to this car. The rear will need to be attached, but look at the large mounting tabs all the way around. So that should make our work easier. Underneath, we've got a headliner molded in, some ejector pin marks you can work on, like all the slot vents. Really nice looking molding for the trim is crisp. Should be able to work that nicely with a Molotow chrome pen. Nice wheel arches on there. Very sharp looking kit. So as usual, I'm going to start gluing my little Firebird together, and I'll be back in just a moment. Thank you. Welcome back, all you styrene fanatics. Well, we saw super easy build session on the 68 Firebird from Revell USA. No problems at all. This thing will be built by modelers of all types. It is a skill level 4 on the box, but come on. This thing, you watched it go together. There's nothing hard to line up. I mean, the suspension bolts right to the chassis, so you're not going to have a problem with lining that up. The differential goes on so easily with these large locating holes, and it's all one piece off the back, so there's no reason why this couldn't be assembled straight and true right out of the box. So you've got your differential, you've got the other half of the differential that we glued in place, and then we just mount that on its axle. The metal pins inside the wheels will just go into those holes, same as it will on the front end. The upper suspension arms really don't determine anything to do with the suspension. They're just there to make sure we've got the correct parts in place, and we glued those on without a problem. The radiator and radiator shroud I'll be painting with the chassis, all one color. I did glue mine in place. The instructions point out not to do that, but as I showed at the end of that build session, it snaps together. The fit is perfect. We're not going to have issues with that. I want to use the center console in mine. I'm not building the drag version, as you saw on the thumbnail when you looked at this video. The seats and the seat backs, look at that. Lovely fit. And when you're done with this tree, you've got a whole extra racing seat. And it is quite a nice seat. Fits around. It's got molded in fabric. So that's very nice. It's a nice accessory. I've got the belt and pulley system together. Now, even though I'm not building the drag version, still may use these track bars. That's why they're on there. And I may paint them and put them on, because very, very, very common thing to do to these cars is add stuff like that. Whether your car can bark the tires or not, cool guys, you always buy stuff like this and bolt it on. It just looks cool. We've got the inside of the grill here. We'll paint that black. We've got the bottom of our air cleaner, and we've got our differential on all of that, so we'll get that sprayed up. Got our door panels. I like to cut off most of the trees, and then I can paint stuff up as I need. We've got our exhaust system. We've got the muffler into duals, and that makes a really clean assembly there. Nice looking, and we've got our tailpipes molded open on this one as well. So yeah, we'll be able to get that bolted in with the exhaust, the dashboard, the rear panel in the body. We'll just push in like so when we're all done, and it fits sort of on the inside. So we'll get that painted up and then attached later with the bumper and all that. Look how nice that hood fits. One thing I didn't show on the video, I forgot, was gluing on the tachometer, but that fits on there beautifully. And then I put the chassis all together and made sure it all sits in there lovely. We don't have any fit issues so far, no problem. So these are the parts that are going to need paint. This is the big dish that will sit by the hood for the air cleaner. We've got our 400 engine together. The distributor actually has the vacuum on it. You can barely see it in the white, but it's on there. We've got our cylinder heads, our stock manifolds. Though you could throw the headers on this thing or save those headers for another project because they really are sharp. Water pump, fuel pump, and I will go with the chrome valve covers. Well, they're probably stock chrome, but and the chrome oil pan. People dress their older cars up all the time. And the steering wheel. So you don't need to, you have the options of doing it either or mix and match. I love doing that kind of stuff. I glued the firewall. It's got a large beam here, so you can't screw up where it goes. Glued that on there. We'll get that painted up, since I'm pretty sure it's black on the real car as well. And we will get everything over into the paint booth right now, get some color on it, come back for the detail session after that. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you're having as much fun as I am. This seems to be a very nice kit with lots of detail, yet again, not so much that it will drive you up the wall with all the little pedantic stuff. We've got some final procedures to go on, but let's look at what we have so far. Right up front is the chassis. I got the blue as close as I can with what's on hand, that bare paint. I've used that 2 videos in a row now, and it seems to work quite well, at least the metallic version. Comes out nice and shiny. The chassis looks awesome. We got our battery in, our fenders, our radiator. We've got the carburetor on and the valve covers. The exhaust system is installed. I did put the traction bars on there. A lot of people will add those onto a car aftermarket. It doesn't have to be just a dragster for the track. The exhaust lines up beautifully, goes underneath the differential and comes out the back, painted the fuel tank, and then just did some gloss work under that chassis just for basic detail, and I like how it turned out. The wheels press in. We've got to add our wheel decals if you so choose to use them. Those will go on. We've got our little air cleaner here that will mount on the square post of the carburetor. It's, you got to turn it around a little bit, but eventually fits on there. That will suck cold air from the ram air. Things I still have to attach are the radiator lines, the nose piece, front bumper of the Firebird with our headlights in place, rear bumper, door handles. Get those on there, and there is a rear view mirror on here somewhere on the chrome tree that I still have to attach as well to the driver's side. The interior actually turned out better than I thought doing it in that green. Those decals, of course, helped tremendously. We got that Rust-Oleum Army Green over black on the door panels. Got our dashboard. We got that fake wood grain plastic on the dash and on the console, so I did a little imitation wood grain. I used the turn signal indicator instead of the stock one. I used the one with the tachometer. Again, super common to bolt into a car later, and the gauges and everything turned out beautifully. That is a really nice interior on the car. Digging that quite a bit. Dark green with a light green door panels and seats and dash. dark green carpeting. On the firewall, I've got the brake booster, the master cylinder in place, and that's it for that. When you do the passenger seat, make sure you slice it out so that the passenger seat will fit. The carpet is molded smooth, and they give you some grooves to cut out underneath. They're identical to the driver's side that you can open up when you want to do the passenger seat. The rear body trim, you saw me just use silver over the paint and then press in the red taillights. Those look awesome. They mount in from the back. Those will look great with our rear bumper pressed into those holes. I've got to add the front marker lights to the body once it's attached. I didn't want to attach them now because I was afraid they'd go flying somewhere. We've got the hood on. Yes, I did do some trim around the hood. I actually saw one. They must have been able to buy this trim or something from some aftermarket place. I also did it around the tack. I just like that since I went through and did all the trim around the body and everything, and we're gonna have trim in these vents here. I figured why not? Did the behind the hood trim, air vents, got the glass glued in as you saw. And that body looks delicious as it is. So all that's really left to do once we get everything put together is put on these red stripes. Possibly use some sort of an emblem off the side. If you want it plain, it can be plain. Put our Firebird logos on, our 400 logos and stuff like that on the air cleaner. Get all that minor work done and that will be it. There's not a lot of work left to do, but it's delicate work. So we're going to take our time. Once I get done with all of that, I will brush on a coat of floor polish onto the body to make it shine, even though that to me is pretty shiny as it is. We'll make it shine a little bit more, and when I get done with all of that, we'll have the final. Check out this little beauty, the 400 cubic inch Pontiac Firebird from 1968. Brought to us by Ravel USA. They sent this one over for a build review, and I was more than happy to build it up. It is a 1/25th scale kit, has 122 parts, not including these excellent decals, which laid down so nice. I used a little bit of decal solvent for the small logos, nothing for the stripe, for the 400 emblems, for the grill, for the trunk lid, that and the red stripes on the tires. I used decal solvent to hold those. The side one didn't need it. They just sunk right into place. It all dried up quickly. Then I brushed over a coat of Future floor polish. You can also use Quick Shine. And this is our result. The door handles fit on so nicely that they're actually held in place with Future floor polish. They pushed right into their little hole. And when we brushed on the floor polish, it did all the rest of the job. So it does fit together pretty well. I keep having issues with this back panel wanting to pop out. I'm going to need to actually push it in and super glue it and use some activator to get it to dry quicker. But for the video's purpose, it fits in nice. It looks nice. The hood fits nice. The front bumper is just held on with Friction and Future run over the crack there. Everything looks great. The glass went in. The interior pops into the body, and you saw how easy the body pops onto the chassis when I was doing the build session. I wanted you to see that. So overall, definite great kit. Not a huge fan of the way the rear end fits in. So I'll say out of 10, I give it a 9. It probably is just me, whatever I'm doing, but it is a weak point in there where it, you know, you got to hold it in, and then after you get the chassis on, then you got to push down and glue it in and then get the bumper in. It can be a little fiddly, but it's not a challenge. Anyone can get it on there. If they have a little bit of extra time, you can just hold it in place and get it to dry, and that's what I'll have to do because I kind of just glued it to the bottom part of the chassis and didn't glue it up here, and I see that it has moved on me, and that's my fault for not gluing it in all the way, but it'll fit right if you take more time. Love that green on green, so kudos to Bob for the one he built for the box art with the green on green, and then I used a white stripe on mine. I used a little bit different shade of metallic green, and then I went for the what we will call baby shite green interior, the dark green carpeting with the much lighter green dash seats and console. Those console decals, as you saw, place perfectly. And with decal solvent, they all just shrink right into the dash. And I was amazed at how well that console decal shrunk down in place as well. I want to thank Revell USA for sending this over. No, I do not know exactly when this will be available. These things kind of just show up from Revell at your favorite hobby shops like ModelRoundup.com whenever they do. So I will get a link over there to Model Roundup as soon as they have one available. I will put it in the description for you guys so you can get an idea of when it might show up. But otherwise, if you ask me in the comments or anyone else, no one really knows. And if they claim they know, they're full of BS. Because if they knew approximately when this was showing up, they would have told me approximately when. But they're not really sure. They just know that they're going to be here in 2024. And that is about all we have to go on right now. So I will see you all at the next video. Have a nice Wednesday. It's supposed to start warming up here in Wisco. It's been 30 below with the wind chills here. So it's been real rough to work out outside, but I've been managing. It'll start warming up by next week. It's supposed to be almost 40 and rainy. So who knows what's going on this year. But keep building those models. Having a good time. We'll see you at the next review.